The beauty of Blackmagic Cloud is that it is simple. Open Resolve, select the Cloud tab, log in if you haven't already, and start working on a project. It is, however, still possible to make mistakes. Even a simple hammer won't work if you grab the wrong end. Here's 5 common mistakes and how to fix them. Our first scenario involves using Blackmagic Cloud to host your project, but not to sync media. Each user that accesses the project will often have a different file path to their media. Even if those different users are just you accessing the project from different computers. Imagine user A works on a Windows machine. They are accessing the media from a network share. Their file path is D media. User B is working on a Mac. They are also accessing the media from the network share. But as they are on a Mac computer, their file path is volumes NAS media. User B sees the media is offline, so relinks it, which makes the media go offline for user A, and they both get into a vicious cycle trying to relink the media so that it works for them. Don't worry. Blackmagic has already provided a solution for that problem. Mapped Mounts allows you to set up permanent aliases for common media locations. These settings are accessed in DaVinci's System Preferences. I'll add the network share as a media location. In the Mapped Mounts column, I'll type in the file path that a Windows user would use to access this share. Now, whenever Resolve sees a reference to D, it will automatically redirect to Volumes Media. I'll reset that so I can demonstrate the second method. When a media location only affects a single project, it's better to use path mapping. This can be accessed in project settings. It works in a similar fashion to Mapped Mounts, but applies just to the project you're currently working on. There's a couple of ways to set up path mapping. Here's the most robust. When the initial editor creates the project, they can visit project settings and add the root directory where their media is installed to this list. If your media is stored in several locations, you can add additional entries here. In each instance, try to add the root folder for each location. Then each subsequent editor that joins the project can head to project settings. They will see the locations the initial editor set up. All they need to do is hit Browse and point Resolve to the corresponding location for each entry on their computer. Don't forget, path mapping relies on media being hosted in identical folder structures. Our next two issues affect multi-user collaboration. Bin, timeline, and clip locking is used to prevent conflicts. After all, you can't have more than one person trying to make changes in the timeline at the same time. On occasion, you might find that another user has locked a resource that you want to gain access to. Let's start by looking at bin locking issues. Has this happened to you? You're trying to work in the media pool, but you cannot make changes or import additional media because the bin is locked. In this instance, I can see the bin is locked to Leon. As he moves around the project, the current bin he is working in will always be locked to him. In this scenario, Leon is editing and moving through bins to access media, but he doesn't need access to write into those bins. Here's 3 solutions. If you don't need write access to a bin, hold down on Option or Alt when clicking on it to open it in read-only mode. Number 2, if I need access to a specific bin that is locked by Leon, I can use Resolve's inbuilt chat feature to ask Leon to leave the bin. And lastly, number 3, while I'm in a bin, Leon will only get read access. Now, if I pop out just for a moment and Leon sneaks in while I'm gone, I'll lose access. To prevent that, right-click on the bin and lock it. Now I can move freely in and out of that bin, and there's no need to worry about losing access. Now let's look at timeline locking issues. Only one user can edit a timeline at a time. However, it is possible for other artists to work on clips within the timeline. The Fusion and Color page both use clip locking. Multiple Fusion artists and colorists can work on individual clips in the timeline while the editor continues to work. Simply open the timeline in read-only mode, and then move to the Fusion or Color page like normal. Please note, when working in Fusion or Color, changes are only committed back to the timeline when you move onto another clip. What about Steph, who wants to work on audio in Fairlight? Or Henry, who wants to make changes to a specific scene? Timeline locking prevents that. There's a simple solution. Make multiple timelines. Steph can duplicate the main timeline and go on working on the audio. As long as major changes are not made to the edit, it's relatively easy to merge work done in either timeline later. It's often easier to merge changes into the audio timeline, as it's harder to copy track effects from one timeline to another. Don't forget, Resolve has the Compare Timelines feature to help you identify differences between timelines. In Henry's case, he should copy just the scenes he wants to work on to a new timeline. Again, once he's finished his work, it can be reintegrated back into the main timeline. These workflows are common in large projects where assistant editors spend time managing edit versions and changes. Resolve's multi-user collaboration and features like Compare Timelines greatly aid this process. Do you share media using Blackmagic Cloud Storage? Are you always running out of space? You can run out of space in your Blackmagic Cloud account, and you can also run out of space on your computer to sync files. So problem one, running out of Blackmagic Cloud Storage. Remove the media from Blackmagic Cloud once the project is finished. Open the project and change the project media syncing either to Do Not Sync Media or Sync Proxies Only. That will stop additional media from being uploaded. To remove the media already in the project, head to your web interface, go to Blackmagic Cloud Storage, find the project, click on the triple dot menu, and select Delete. We'd recommend removing media once a project has completed. Problem two, running out of storage on your computer. When working on cloud projects, like we've mentioned previously, the media gets synced to your computer. You might have a terabyte of storage in the cloud, but you might not have a terabyte of storage on your computer. What can you do about that? First, you could purchase additional storage. Something like this is Blackmagic's own storage solution, the Cloud Store. You can configure Resolve to sync your cloud media to this device rather than your computer. Even better, you can actually configure your Cloud Store to automatically download media from Blackmagic Cloud. There's a couple advantages to that. Firstly, if you have more than one editor in your office, they can all access the media in one location rather than everyone synchronizing their own copies. Secondly, as this thing runs independent of your computer, it can sync in the background while you're working on other stuff, or even overnight so it's ready in the morning. Let's say you don't have one of these though. What can you do? Here's a couple ideas. Firstly, synchronize proxies only. They take up way less space than originals. If you're collaborating on someone else's project and you're not expected to make the final delivery, this is an excellent solution. This obviously doesn't work though if you're the project host having to store the original media or if you're making the final delivery. Number two, use a regular external drive. Remember, every time you start a cloud project, Resolve asks you where you want to synchronize the cloud media. Just choose your external drive. And lastly, number three, delete old projects. Head to the folder where Resolve stores your cloud media on your computer, locate the folder that shares the same name as your project, and just delete it. Don't worry, this isn't deleting your project. That's safe on the cloud. It's just deleting your local copy of the media. If you open the project again, as long as the media has not been removed from Blackmagic Cloud, it will re-download. Have you ever had the scenario where you want to give someone access to a specific project on your cloud project library, but you don't want them to have access to all your other projects? The solution is to create additional project libraries. Yes, this will require additional money, but remember, a project library costs less than $6 a month. Here's an example of how you might use this. You start a new project that requires you to collaborate with freelancers. Head to the Blackmagic Cloud web interface, modify your plan by increasing the number of libraries. Then create a new library and share it with the relevant workers. When the production's finished, move the projects back into your primary project library and delete the project library and revise your plan. If your project is completed within 2 months, you've only had to spend $12 on the additional project library, a cost that can be easily passed on to your client. Hope you found these solutions helpful. If you did, please give the video a like and subscribe to see even more Resolve tutorials. Thanks for watching.